Thanks for tuning in to this 14th episode of my live stream revealing my knife collection. Let's talk about the COVID-19 pandemic first. In the Netherlands, the numbers of COVID patients are increasing, but I don't know if they also count in the regular flu patients. So I don't know, but I think not much to worry about. But the COVID pandemic has some implications, of course. For example, shipping will give delays. Last week, on Monday, I shipped something to Australia. Austria. And normally that will arrive within 4 or 5 days. But it still hasn't left our country. That's just an example. And I think it's due to the corona, the COVID restrictions. Another example is some projects of manufacturers have huge delays because of the lockdown earlier this year. Just an example, a manufacturer from China sent a prototype the first week of March. That project already had a delay because they were intending to introduce a new collaboration with a Dutch knife maker during the first week of March during IWA in Nuremberg. And because of the lockdown, that was not able to get it done. And then they shipped the prototype, the final prototype, the first week of March to Europe. And just 2 weeks ago, I received the prototype. In the meantime, they had shipped 2 new prototypes because it was they lost track. So in total, 3 packages were shipped with 3 prototypes. And 2 weeks ago, I received 1 package with a prototype. I don't know which package it was, the first, the second, or the third. So the COVID pandemic gives a lot of causes a lot of problems, delays. So for the people who are buying knives from me, just be patient. It will arrive, but it can cause some delay. Previous packages within Europe didn't have delay at all, but the package last week to Austria now has a delay of now already, I think, 4 days, 5 days delay, but it will arrive. So, okay, let me check who's in. Good evening, Dimitri. Hi, Stefan. Hi, John. Here we are again, exactly. Dimitri, I had sold a knife to the United States. It took exactly 5 months to arrive. PostNL, so that is also a huge delay. Jeroen, goedenavond. Welcome. Okay, so I have some, in this episode, I've mostly Chinese made knives on the table. There is one exception. And some of those you already have seen 2 episodes ago in the Bestech special. But I found out I have, from certain models, I have more than one. So I put, again, 3 on the table that I have, from which I have more than one in the collection. So I will start with those. And actually, that's not bad at all, because those are very beautiful knives. And then some more of Bestech. steelcraft or Tobac knives. I have some of those. A couple of custom knife factory knives, steel wheel, real steel. And then the exception is cold steel that is made in Taiwan. So also kind of China, but okay. So let's get started. The first are from Bestek, and the first three I already showed in a previous episode, two episodes ago, but those I have more than one. The first one is the Dolphin, and I think I already told in episode 12, I really like the Dolphin. It's a very beautiful knife. Especially the anodization in combination with the stone wash and then the really subtle milling on the frame in combination with the blade. I really like the Dolphin or BT1707. So this was the seventh design in 2017. And as you can see, probably this is, I don't know if it shows, but this is number five of the first production run of 100. So a very low number. I don't know the number of the previous one, but it was also, I think, also the first production run, the first 100. So this is number five. The Dolphin, really beautiful, beautiful knife. Okay, next up. And this is the Starfighter. I hope my camera will focus. The Starfighter. It's more colorful. Full titanium S35 VN blade steel. And this one. Yeah, S35 blade steel, just as the previous one. Titanium clip, sculpted, so beautiful knife. The Starfighter. Let me show it in this camera as well for the lightning. What I like on this one is the combination of the high flat satin brush in combination with the stone wash on the rest of the blades. Hi Daniel, good evening. I'm fine. I hope you are fine as well. Hi, Wolf Reaper 88. So, okay. Next up, this is the Shogun, and this is the number 89 of the first production run of 100. Full titanium S35 VN blade steel, ceramic bearings. So pretty smooth. Nice knife, nothing, not. Oh, and this is why I also showed it the second time. As you can see here, this one has the old logo BTK. Bestek knives, but they only had it on the first three models, and then Bestek found out that BTK was not such a good logo for English-speaking countries because it also means born to kill. And from that moment on, they used the best tag full written best tag. So you don't find a lot of best tag knives with BTK on it. Okay. So those three were shown in a previous episode, but I have more than one of these. Next up, and I really dig this design, this is the Torsell or BT1708. I hope my camera will focus. I really like this design. Great action. It's a kind of a modified clip point. Let me show it in this camera for the lightning. This lighting is better. And this is also a low number, I think. Oh, no, sorry. Not this one. And very much details, very much milling work on the frame. Nice anno work with accent, blue accents. Possibility for a lanyard. Backspacer along 1/3 of the frame. Jimping on top. And this one is, let me see. This one is number 2. From 100. I don't know if you see it on the spine of the blade, number 2 of 100. So a very low number. The Torsell. Very nice knife. Number 2 of 100. Then another one. Oh, and the Torsell, I think it was with M390. Yeah, M390. The Torsell is with M390. Another one, and this is what I consider the most beautiful Bestek design they have. This is the Predator. Full titanium, carbon fiber onlay, Tento design. I really like this one. And this one has number 0 from 100. So pretty special. Nice blue anno work on the frame with gold accents and then the carbon fiber. A big slot on the blade. And you can even use it to if you practice, you can use it to open it. I can't do it, but I know people who can do it. So really nice knife, the Predator or BT1706. And pretty special with the low number. This was my first Bestek knife, not this particular one. I learned to know Bestek because of a mass drop deal, and I saw this one in two varieties, a golden variety and I think this one, maybe, I don't know exactly. And this one is called the Emperor or BT1703, and so I ordered two from mass drop. And I really liked it very much. And because of the mass drop deal, it was pretty affordable. This is also with the old logo, BTK, so Born to Kill. And not a lot of Bestek knives are made with BTK on it. And this is the first production run number 25 from 150 made. So also a pretty low number. In fact, all numbered knives are all very low numbers. So, and of course, all the current Emperors are made with the new logo. So, I hope you like it so far. Then a very fun knife, I think. This is the Imp or the BT1710. So the 10th model in 2017. And besides of the Imp, they had another small one. And I have it somewhere around the other one as well. And they looked very much similar, very similar. But I forgot the name. But this is the Imp. A very useful small knife. It really melts in your hand. Very controllable during EDC tasks. Yeah, premium materials, S35 VN blade steel, titanium frame, ceramic bearings, carbon fiber scale. And that is very, very nice. The price range of the Predator, I'm not sure, John. I really don't know what price range. I think it's a guess. I think in the price range of 250. Give it a Google search, and then it pops up. In Europe, I think 250, something like that. Well, if you have a moment, I can do a search myself. Bestech Predator. Let me see. In Europe, around 210 euro. They lowered the price, originally 250 euro. And in the United States, let me see. United States, $200. Yeah. Okay. Let me see, where am I? So this is the Imp. Very fun knife and very useful. Very practical as EDC knife. Next one, I really like this one. This is the Sapphire or BT1705. And I hope the camera will focus. No. Yes, there it is. This is a very small knife. Hi, Knife Force. Good evening. This is a very small knife, S35 VN blade steel, titanium frame. I think it weighs 30 gram or something like that. It's really very light. And what a nice detail is that it also has a lanyard possibility. You can flip this out. And then you also can attach a lanyard. So, also from titanium. And if you don't use it, you can flip it in again. And let me show it in my hand so you can see how small it is. It's really, yeah, the name Sapphire, I think it's well chosen because of the colors and because it's really pocket jewelry. Very nice knife. And this is a first production run. And this is also number 0 from 100. Yeah, from 100. As you can see, possibly 0 from 100, the Sapphire. And then another small one is the Zen. That's this one. This is a very small one as well, same length as the Sapphire, approximately. Let me show them together. Even a little bit shorter, but a little bit more robust, as you can see. A little wider blade and a little bit more meat on the frame. So, but also a very nice small EDC knife for in your suit, in the pocket of your suit, or for in the purse of your wife. So if you have a very lovely wife and you have something, you need a present for her. Hi, Lion. Hi, Dogan. Thank you for your notification. Okay. So then this kind of knives are very, very beautiful. This is the Zen S35 VN blade steel full titanium frame. So very beautiful small pocket knives. So that were the Bestek knives. I have a lot more Bestek knives. So possibly in next episodes, I will show some Bestek knives again and also the budget models. But I really like Bestek knives. Only I think after 2019, I didn't buy Bestek knives anymore. So 2017, 2018, I bought quite a number of Bestek knives. Okay, next up, that's a brand that I really like very much. That's Todd Beck knives. And they had Todd Beck knives. Todd Beck, of course, is the famous knife maker from the United States. And Todd Beck knives was the company of Todd Beck and his brother Mark, another guy, and they established this company, Todd Beck Knives, and Todd only gave the designs of his custom work, and the other guys did the mass production with factories in China, and most of the time they used Riyadh knives for the manufacturing of the knives for the mass production. And sometimes they used Wee knife. And the mass produced knives in China were called the Steelcraft series. And they are all designed after custom designs of Todd Beck. And the first Steelcraft knives I bought was the Quaken, and I really dig this design, the Quaken of the Steelcraft Quaken from Todd Beck. It's a Quaken, just as the name implies. It's made by Riyadh Knives, S35 VN blade, titanium frame, lot of details, and then the clip with the D10 ball for easy in and out of the pocket, as Todd Beck invented it. Well, he thought of it. He was the first to use a D10 ball in the pocket clip. And this one has a lot of details. Very beautiful gray stonewashed blade and a lot of milling work in the frame, as you can see. Just a beautiful, beautiful knife with a phenomenal action. It's a frame lock, and let me show it on this camera if it focuses. Oh, that's me. Great action. Really great action. Very smooth ceramic bearings. The Steelcraft Quaken. Beautiful knife. And then this one, this is The Glimpse. This was the first series produced by WeKnife for Steelcraft, for top back knives. And The Glimpse was made in several varieties. This is the Louis Vuitton variety. And I think in total 50 or 25 were made of the Louis Vuitton variety. And it's called the Louis Vuitton variety because of the coloring. This one is with the S35 Fien blade, G10 scales, titanium liners, titanium backspacer, titanium clip, just as Todd Beck designed it with the D10 ball. Great knife. I really like it. And you can recognize Todd Beck in this knife. Great ergos. The chawl is really very useful. Let me show it in this camera as well. It's just a beautiful knife. A fluted groove in the blade. So very, very beautiful lines. And smooth, very smooth. So the Glimpse. Of course, you color design is just personal preference, but I really dig this one. And I bought this from Mark, the brother of Todd Beck, during IWA, I think. IWA 2017 or 2018. So, The Glimpse. And then some other Chinese-made knives. This is from Custom Knife Factory. This is one of the first high-end custom knife factory knives. This is the Garza. And this is also my favorite custom knife factory knife. I owned a lot of custom knife factory knives. I think there was a time I had 14 or 15 different models from Custom Knife Factory. But most of them I already sold. And this one... this was my first, and I don't know if I am able to sell this one because I really love this one. This is the Garza S35 Fien blade, full titanium frame, very nice anodization work, and very subtle milling. Let me show it in this camera. Very subtle milling work on the frame. I hope it shows. I don't think it shows on the camera, but really a very nice, this is a beauty. I really like this one. It's not a flipper, it's with thumb studs, but it's very, very smooth. Full-sized, nice 3D milled pocket clip. Very, very smooth. The Garza from Custom Knife Factory. And you can't get these anymore. Maybe on the secondary market. This was a design from 2013, from the early beginning of Custom Knife Factory. And then another Custom Knife Factory knife I like, design I like. And the Garza is, by the way, Malyshev design. And then this one, this is the same. This is the Trecosa, and the Trecosa is Koningin design. And this is the Trecosa. So originally, the Trecosa was introduced with these transparent scales. And you just have to like it. Not everybody likes this. But this is a super light knife. It's a full-sized 4-inch blade. Hi, Björn. Guten Abend. Ja, schönes custom knife factory. super light because of the heavy milling on the frame. And then those scales, those transparent scales, kind of acrylic, are very, very light. So this knife weighs almost nothing. But not everybody likes this with the transparent scales. So after half a year or after a year, they also introduced carbon fiber scales on the market. So aftermarket scales from carbon fiber. And then it looks like this. So this one also has the original scales with it, but I attached the carbon fiber scale so you can see the difference. I really dig it. It's a very nice design. And then I also have the Sablia. Sablia is also an early design of Custom Knife Factory. I think also 2013 or 2014. But I don't know where I have the Sablia, but I have it somewhere around. And that's all what is left from Custom Knife Factory. So the Garza, Tricosa, two pieces of this Tricosa and a Sablia. That's all what is left from Custom Knife Factory. All the rest I have sold. By the way, sales are doing very well. I already sold quite some knives last week's. Even today, I sold 3 knives. So that's going pretty well. And then next up, this one is also made in China. This is the Steelwheel Apostate. This was a gift from a good friend, Wesley, in the United States. And this one I carried a lot. But after I had it sharpened by my friend Jeffrey, I didn't use it anymore. But it's about time I'm going to EDC this one again. So this was a very budget-friendly EDC-able knife, big knife, 4-inch blade, S35 Fien blade steel, G10 scale, titanium frame, steel hardware, just a simple steel clip, but very useful. And I EDC'd this knife a lot, and it's very, very good. Goedenavond, Wouter. All my knives are for sale through my YouTube channel. On my YouTube channel, you can see all knives that are for sale. Nice that you are here, Wouter. It's quite some time ago that we spoke. I think 4 months ago. So the Steelwheel Apostate. This one is not for sale, of course. This was a gift. So I'm pretty glad with the Steelwheel Apostate. But this was a very budget-friendly high-end knife. I think they sold for, I don't know, I think they are discontinued. But I think they sold for around $150. So when they were introduced, it was quite a very budget-friendly price for a knife with S35 VN blade steel and a titanium frame. So the Steelwheel Apostate. Very useful if you like big knives. And then another one made in China. This is a real steel knife. You can see that it is used. I also have a brand new one in a package. And this is the 2017 Megalodon with M390. I'm not sure, but I think so. Let me check. Sorry, moment. One moment. Yeah, this is with M390. So this is the 2017 Megalodon Carson design. So one of the premium high-end models of real steel. And it's just a very useful, very light, very practical, and just beautiful lines. The real steel Megalodon. And I liked it so much, so I also bought one to keep it brand new. So, very smooth. Carson design. The original Megalodon was the boiling flipper and had a closed pivot system. So, I never managed to find one, because those were sold out very, very quickly around 2013, 2014, I think, and I never managed to find one. So the real steel Megalodon, and then made in Taiwan, cold steel, code 4. This one has seen a lot of use and a lot of abuse. Just an awesome knife with the XHP steel. Very smooth, it's backlock, but you can use it with one hand, open and close it with one hand. It's very smooth, and I even batoned with this knife. The only drawback of the Code 4 is the aluminum scale. In wet conditions, it is a kind of slippery, and I've seen some solutions from people taping grip tape on it, or making scratches on it, but I never saw the need of this, but I really dig the cold steel in general, because they are very strong, well-built knives, and the Code 4, it's very light and very capable, so I used it a lot, the Code 4, made in Taiwan, and all the rest is made on the China mainland. Okay, that was it for this evening for the episode 14, but I have a bonus knife, and that's the Proto I talked about that arrived 2 weeks ago. The prototype is made after the original of the original Martin Annegarn Street Legal. This is a custom Martin Annegarn Street Legal, Dutch knife maker, slip joint, and it's an awesome knife with very nice walk and talk, half stop, nice wood. And Martin has a collaboration with a Chinese manufacturer, Tuya Knife, and this is the final prototype. There will be some improvements, but parts are already in production. So as we speak, parts are being produced, and it will be available around Black Friday before Christmas. So if you are looking for a nice gift for Christmas, I can really recommend this. And I just promote this knife because Martin is a good friend of me, and I hope his collaboration will be successful. That's why I also have the prototype. So this is the prototype from the Street Legal. Very nice hollow grind. Very nice desert ironwood. There will be some improvements on the final production version, such as the pivot and some other improvements I won't mention here. But as you can see, very similar to the custom version of Martin himself. By the way, Martin makes the Street Legal in two varieties, a small one and a big one. The custom version is the big one, but the production version will be the small one. So this will really be legal in most countries because of the size. It's a 3-inch blade, and because of that it is two-hand opening. And as you can see, it's very, very easy to close, but it is very secure because you need 1 kilogram of pressure to close it. And because it has not a clip on it, you can see a clip, it comes with a leather sheet with a clip attached. So you can use a leather sheet, and the leather sheet will be darker, more matching with the wood. So that's another improvement. And the price will be the MSRP price. So the maximum price will be around $150-$160, and street prices around $120. So for Europe, probably because we have tax and that kind of stuff, probably around 130 to 150 euros, somewhere around. But it's also depending on the dollar. Right now, the dollar is pretty low in comparison with the euro, so it could be a little bit lower even, but somewhere around 130, 150. Maybe lower, maybe less. So I'm very excited because if everything will go around, will go good, it will be available in the end of November. But I refer to my introduction with the COVID-19 pandemic, the delay of some projects and delay in shipping. We have to wait and see. If the COVID lockdown will also hit China and the rest of Europe, it can take longer. But I hope they will get the deadline of November, end November. So it's a very beautiful gift for Christmas. Steel type, Wouter, M390. So for the blade steel, M390. And for the liners and the backspacer, titanium. And the highest grade, desert ironwood. So really premium materials. And I really like it. The prototype already is very good. I have another prototype, by the way. That was the first prototype. Let me show it as well. So this was the first prototype. And this was a lower grade of desert ironwood, because that was the only grade of ironwood available at that time. Some improvements between prototype 1 and prototype 2. Look at the flat swatch, for example. The blade is more back to the frame in the second prototype, as you can see. So there are already improvements between prototype 1 and 2. So this is very, very promising. Okay, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. So most of my knives are for sale. Just watch previous episodes. If you need a list, I am compiling each week. I compile my list again with the new episode additions. So if you want to receive that list, just send me an email. My email address is in the description box. If you want to talk on WhatsApp, my phone number is in the description box. Yeah, that's about it. So I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope to see you again next week, Tuesday, 8 p.m. sharp. Good evening all. Bye-bye.